Sorry, Portland suits.
So right now we got Silver versus Space Gamer. Winner's finals. Winner of this is guaranteed grand finals and a copy of Pokemon Sun or Moon from the sub tournament. Both these players have pretty rough brackets to get here. Let's see what happens. Right now, Silver is definitely putting in work, showing us he is a very much range. I think Space Gamer just expected to be safe, but all that range is so hard to be ready for Marth. And there we go. Game one going solidly to Silver. We're about to see our first member of the Grand Finals, because I think we are. And now with the counterpicks and stuff. Okay, now we got song requests going, so let's see what you guys have posted for me. And you know, we need a different me now. You know, this me is beautiful. Got... Why would her... She is. She's like a super generic looking me that I just made. For the hell of it. Ooh, just a Tesper. What's that emote? That's a nice ass emote. Yo, this song though, thank you to Isla for suggesting this song. Definitely saving this to my channel playlist, just saying. Oh, we got a switch to Falcon from Space Gamer? Interesting. Interesting choice on FD2. I mean, I guess... because he's so fast, he's able to abuse his speed to just kind of pressure Marth and, like, approach, but... I'm not sure if Falcon can really get in Marth's zone. I feel like Marth's zone, despite Falcon's speed, would just be too much. And, like, Falcon would have to make too hard of commitments to really do anything, where Marth is just kind of... gonna get to play his game, throw attacks out. And I'm not sure if Falcon's gonna be able to do against, like, just... attacks, honestly. As silly as that sounds, just throwing out attacks seems like a very good idea. He's here now, just, yeah. Silver is just kind of going in. Space Gamer is really not able to do anything. Like, full up air, landing, back airs, neutral airs, all this stuff. And when Space Gamer gets in, it's not enough damage. I mean, this is good damage, but he needs to, like, take a stock. Especially when you see Silver puts him in the air and just does, like, 40 to 50 a Falcon. Because Falcon gets juggled by every character. Even characters without combos do 50% combos to Falcon. That's how unfortunate life is for him. Nice. Nice forward tilt. That's it. This should be a stock. Oh, he went for his style. And... oh, he went for the read. It's not going to work. And we need a game... what is Space Gamer's plan for game 3? Because this game is already over outside of some super lucky stuff. Outside of something like a kill now and two down throw down here. Oh, just forward smash. And I feel like that was a reaction from Silver. Silver is really good at waiting for stuff and then punishing. And there, it's game two. Very solid. I think there's another JV. Oh no, it wasn't JV. That was two stock. So yeah. And now we have one more game for Silver before he's in the Grand Finals. What is Space Gamer going to pull out now? Because his entire game plan is just not working. He's really getting baited hard by Silver, but he's also just getting out-neutraled. And yeah. I really don't know what I would do if I was Silver right now. I would say go back to switch back to Corrin and see what happens from there, that's for sure. But otherwise, yeah. You think Silver was seeded 27. He basically didn't even have a seed. And he's just putting in work. Look at this beautiful me. Oh, he's staying Falcon, okay. This is an interesting choice to just stay Falcon. I'm wondering why he's doing this. Does he just not know what to do? Maybe he has a plan. I think he needs to play a lot more patient versus Silver, because Silver seems very adept at just punishing aggressive play. At really taking advantage of someone's impatience and telling them they cannot be impatient. And yeah, dash attack, up air, up air, up air, up air. Up air, up air, up air. Okay, that's enough up airs. Up air, up air. Nice forward smash. That's almost a gimp. Okay, this game's going a lot better for Space Gamer. He's still losing, but he's putting up some damage. Gets a punish here. Gotta convert. He's gotta convert that to damage. Back air. Baits out the forward air. Oh, he's in a bad spot. Up throw won't kill yet. Will it? Okay, now it will. Yeah, everyone's letting Silver get a look at the throws. Oh, like, Silver cut that couple combos in through. But Falcon's a heavy character. Heavy, high gravity. He's not going to have to top easily at all. Oh, that should be a kill, though. Yep. Bad DI. Always DI Marth throws behind you. It'll let you live by, like, 1%. Which isn't much in the long run, but still 1%. Down throw, back air. Nice side B. Oh, but no rage. And side B's only really good kill option with rage. Back air, and that's a... nope, not quite. Right now, Silver needs extra credit, but he's in a really bad spot, yeah. Yeah, he couldn't do much there. He's on the ledge. He had to take a 50-50 from everything. But now he respawns, puts in the pressure, and Space Gamer is getting pressured. Nice forward smash. Oh, he goes for read. This could be a chance for Space Gamer. But he's not getting enough damage, no. Space Gamer's strings aren't, like, clean enough. Considering that Marth is getting, like, 10 damage per swing on his sword, getting a 15 damage grab string when it's hard to get grabs in the first place is just not going to be enough. Oh my god, the air dodge. That was a really bad air dodge. Two frame, that's it. That should be... Oh, no, he misses the edge guard. I think if Faraday was better... Oh, B! First leg. And there we go. Just like that. That is a 3-0 in favor of Silver. Very dominant performance. Space Cable is starting to get things at the end, but he really needs more damage output. I don't think he'd do much in neutral except play patient. Maybe dash back and forth a bit more via Space Gamer to kind of create openings from Silver. Because Silver does leave himself open, I think, if you try to bait him. But if you're not doing that, yeah, Silver's hard to hit. So good stuff to him.